Praise the Lord. Welcome to 27 of this podcast. Father, we just thank you for this fire you have helped us. And I pray as I speak this word again today, let this people be baptized by the spirit of your help. That will bring champions out of nobodies. That will make heroes and heroines out of people that have no titles. That will cause them to be mighty weapons in the hand of the Almighty. Bringing out the giants against the church of God in this decade. I trust you that this be done. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I want to talk to us today about what I titled, Operating the Spirit of Yahel. Operating the Spirit of Yahel. I've said it over and again that Nigerian church worships prayer, not God. And we need to begin to worship God. When I talk about operating the Spirit of Yahel, I'm sure the first thing that comes to mind is to begin to pray, oh God, give me the spirit of Yahel. Give me the spirit of Yahel. Give me the, oh God. Yeah, it's good to pray. But I want you to know that you have to put leg into your prayers. Praise God. Somebody says, if you pray for food, you go along with your basket. Praise God. I want you to understand that when you say somebody is operating the spirit of fornication, he started up fornicating by willpower. And by the time he gives himself to it so much, then the spirit of fornication takes him over. There are people that steal, there are people that operate by the spirit of theft, of stealing. When you give yourself over to it over a long time, you become a slave of it, then a spirit takes over. That is what happens when people say they are delivered but not delivered. You see, when you cast out such a spirit of stealing, the man still has to use his willpower by his powers. Allow the Spirit of God to work with his heart to be able to stop the stealing even when it's not under the compulsion of the Spirit. Because it started actually by his own willpower. Why am I saying all this? You need to go back to the things that we have said about the characteristics of or the lessons that we learned from Yahel. His ability to painfully and patiently wait for God's timing and opportunity. Ability to recognize God's Kairos moments. Alacrity at seizing Kairos moments. Not giving heed to any excuse whatsoever. Courage to do the needful for God when God calls for it. And different other great attributes you have seen in the life of your health. When you begin to live your life this way, consistently and progressively better and better by the day, you will not know when the same spirit begins to operate in your life. Praise God. This is what I want to share with us today. It's important for every one of us to understand that this spirit came upon this woman because she was always sighing and crying. He saw that this thing that is happening is an aberration, is an abomination. But she did not just remove her eyes and say, well, there's nothing I can do about it. I can't change the world. So what do I do? She was concerned. Though she couldn't see how she could be of use, but that burden attracted God to him, to her. Look at David, the shepherd. It was his heart that attracted God to him. Look at how God jumped over 7 elder brothers and came to that boy because of his heart. Because of the kind of heart that this woman kept, God was able to locate her, a woman that was not even a Jewess, to bring deliverance to God's people. In Ezekiel chapter 9, verse 4, we read that some days ago. He said, and the Lord God said unto him, go through the midst of the city. That was the Incan writer. Through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of men that sigh and cry for all the abomination that be done in the midst thereof. If we seem to not to be concerned, we say, well, thank God I don't have a child in that age range. Thank God I don't have a female child. Thank God I don't have a male child. Thank God I'm not into business. And we begin to shelve responsibility of intercession. You hear how the Malian spirit is ravaging the whole country among the youth, and you are not doing anything about it. You are not raising a voice. You are not raising a prayer. You are not doing anything about it. You are not traveling in prayers for the young people of the nation. You say, well, thank God my children are grown up. Brothers and sisters, you are far from the spirit that we're talking about. And you will not be among such people that God can use in this decade that we're going into. Because it's going to be a decade that God will depend heavily on people that are unmarked. Hallelujah. A lot of people have been marked, have been disqualified. Not all, but I want you to know that God will begin to depend heavily on people that we call normal saints. people like Ananias that went to pray for Saul when on his way, when he was going to Damascus, when he became blind. Just such are the people that God is going to use more and more going forward, not only in this decade. I gave that prophecy about 2 years ago when we had the Labor Ministers Conference, that God will begin to use small clusters and people who have no titles to begin to achieve great things in the body of Christ. If you want to belong to that league, you need to begin to consistently give yourself to sighing and crying against whatever is happening in your life. Even when you think you are incapacitated, when you think you don't have what it takes to give, you can do something. You can sigh. You can cry. You can wail against it. You can do whatever is within your own purview to be able to do about it. Don't say it's too small. You remember when Jesus was going to feed 5,000? Then what have you? They say, when he was going to feed 4,000, we say, what have you? They say, well, we just have 7 loaves and a few fishes. Say, but what can that do? Before he said anything, what can that do among men? He said, you bring it. Just bring the little you have. Don't worry that it's small. We spoke yesterday about not giving it to excuses. Bring the little you have. You call it little. When you put it in my hands, it's no longer little. When they put it in your hands, he blessed the Lord and gave this little back to them. The little became much in their own very hands. Hallelujah. That is what God expects us to do in this generation. God is not expecting us to begin to be looking up to some one big guy somewhere to come and do it. You are the best soldier that God has on ground wherever you find yourself. Don't try and look for the general. Even if you think you're a corporal, you are the one that is on ground. You are the one to do the job. And if you trust God, he will accomplish it through you. Praise the Lord. When you pray the spirit of your health, begin to consciously and progressively do those things that you have held it, those things that we have been able to bring out from the word of God, the things that brought us to that point. If you begin to yield yourself to them, do them consciously, do them consistently, do them progressively more and more, you will realize that before you know it, the spirit that works that kind of thing begin to operate in your life as you trust God in doing your bit in this generation. I pray that the Almighty God will see to it that everything that he has put in your heart is fulfilled as you go according to this counsel. God bless you. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.